Yo, what's up? It's Patrick from Guy in a Cube, and I've been working on these end-to-end data solutions in Fabric. I started creating these notebooks. One notebook depended on another notebook, so the first notebook had to run before the other notebooks can run, and I had this whole chain of notebooks, and I needed to do some orchestration. And so I did a quick search on the internet, and I found this Learn document from Microsoft that showed me how to run notebooks in parallel, and that was exciting because I can run the top-level ones, and then the next one, and the next one. But then I scroll further down, and then there's this thing called a DAG. It's like a graph. I'm going to talk about this way to run your notebooks in parallel, and I'm also going to talk about the DAG. All right, so enough of all this talking. I'm excited. You know what I like to do? Let's head over to my laptop. So let's start with this article. And down in the article, there's a section, reference multiple notebooks in parallel. And I landed right here, and I'm like, oh, well, this is easy. Notebooks run multiple, and just give it a comma separated list of your notebooks. So what I did was I went over here, I created a notebook, and I ran it, and it ran great. And so like if I kick this off, just give it the notebook names that you want to run in parallel. And you can see it kick those off and it runs those. And I'm like, all right. So I created another cell. So the ones that I want to run first, I put those in one cell and they ran. The ones I wanted to run after that, I put them in another cell and they ran. And that was great. But then I started thinking, I may have dependencies. Well, even though I want those to run first, I need the other ones to run depending on the first ones. I know, kind of confusing. And then I scroll further down in the document and it says, hey, here's an example of running notebooks with a topological structure using runMultiple. This method easily orchestrate notebooks through a code experience. And there's this thing called a DAG, right? It's a graph. And so you create this JSON document and you provide these parameters and then it would run it in this order. And then one of the parameters is dependencies. And so this notebook wouldn't run until this notebook ran. And so wait a minute, what is this DAG thing? This is what everybody's been talking about. So I decided, hey, I'm going to go out and create me a DAG. So I went over into my notebook. I wrote my DAG up. And so the root is activities. And then you can see here's the first notebook. And then this particular notebook, the incremental table one, depends on that first notebook, which means this notebook won't run until this notebook runs. And then the same thing here. This notebook is at the node. And then this is on the edge. So this notebook won't run until this notebook runs. And then you just say notebook utils.notebook run multiple. The first parameter would be the DAG, and then you can add some additional parameters. And before I go on any further, shout out to Sandeep Pawar, the Fabric guru, wrote a great document that helped me along my journey. Anyway, so if you go here and run this now, what you'll see is that it's going to fire up all four. Everybody's queued here. And then eventually you'll see, hey, this one doesn't have any dependency. It's in progress. This one doesn't have any dependency. It's in progress. And they'll start running. And once they complete, the other ones will queue up. And then they'll start running based on the success or completion of its dependency. So you can see how this one succeeded. And this one's already in progress. It's not waiting for that one to succeed. So now I have this really great typological notebook orchestration. But then I start thinking, wait a minute. I gotta modify this JSON and go into this notebook every time that I want to do this, but I did not want to modify that JSON. I just needed something to generate that JSON for me. And then a light bulb went off and I was like, SQL database has a graph feature that I can use for JSON in SQL that can generate the JSON with me. So I went on a journey and that's where the fun began. So you can see before we jump over into all my SQL stuff that notebook's completed and it even shows you a little picture. Hey, these two ran first, but these didn't start until those completed. It's pretty nice. But back to the SQL. I created a Fabric SQL database in Fabric. So you'll need a Fabric SQL database and you'll need VS Code, not to write any code. So I created two tables. The first table is my parameters table. And this contains every possible parameter that DAG requires. And I just used Copilot and Copilot told me all of those parameters. So I created that and I specified this as a node because like I said, SQL has graph built into it. And then I created a depends on table as the edge. And then what I did, I created some stored procedures because I needed to add data into these tables. So I created a stored procedure that would add my node, all the parameters as an option, and it just inserted it. And then I created another stored procedure that just added the edges based on the names of the notebooks. And then I use four JSON path. And you can see here's the root, which is activities. Because if you look at the DAG, the document itself, activities at the root. And then I use this JSON array to create my dependencies. And there's lots of stuff. And I'll make sure that these code samples are in the description of the video below if somebody wants to give this a try. So got all this created and I created a stored procedure called generate DAG. And if I go over here, I'm going to run this. It actually generates the JSON for me. I'm going to go ahead, copy this out, head over to VS Code. I'm going to paste this in. And then I'm going to format this document and you'll see, boom, there's the JSON that it produced, but I'm missing one of my dependencies. So all you need to do is go over here and execute the two stored procedures. Every notebook has to be added as a node in this solution. So I'm going to go ahead and run this. Cross your fingers, cross your toes. All right, that ran. And then I'm going to run this one because it has a dependency. So I'm going to run that as the edge. And then I'm going to generate my DAG here. Copy this, paste this over here into VS Code, format it up. And you can see my entire graph, right? So these two will run first, and then these two have dependencies on those two. So now all I need to do is copy this, go back over to my notebook, paste it in, it's the exact same thing, and run it. So now I don't have to type this thing up over and over again. I can run it, I have my orchestration, and I don't have to worry about typing the JSON, messing it up, because I've tested it, and it generates a pretty well-formed document for me. But the problem is, every time I generate one of these DAGs, I got to go and copy and paste and touch my notebook and possibly break something. That's not good. Remember, I'm not lazy. I'm just really efficient. I started thinking there's got to be a way to automate this. But you got to wait for the next video to see that. All right. If you've been working with DAGs, you have any questions, comments, definitely go check out the Learn document and Sandeep's blog post. Both of them are essential to learning how to use this. If you have any questions, comments, post them in the comments below. If you want to learn more about Fabric, all the workloads, it's a video flying above my head. And as always, Martha, Adam, this guy. Thanks for watching. See you in the next video.